Marshall D. Teach, a.k.a. Blackbeard, is a man full of mysteries, but what if I told you that this man's father has just been revealed? Now, yo, I don't know how Oda does it, but he has managed to drop the greatest One Piece chapter of the year after he dropped so many bangers. And all I gotta say is that if you are a fan of One Piece and you haven't read chapter 957, can you really call yourself a fan of the series? Like, let's be honest, can you really call yourself a fan of the series? But no, in all seriousness, today I'll be doing a video discussing Blackbeard's father and the Rocks Pirates, because yo, we got a lot of things to discuss. And we now know that Blackbeard's father was potentially the first pirate king ever. Now, all I'm gonna say is that it is hype because Big Mom and Kaido are confirmed Rocks Pirates 2.0, and that's some big news because we know that the Rocks Pirates, they were basically the greatest, I will call them the greatest pirate group of all time. And the fact that these two combined are equal to them goes to show you that these guys are some sicko savages. And speaking of the Rocks Pirate, the long-awaited time, they've finally been revealed, because we found out that the Rocks Pirates, they were actually a group of pirates who just killed each other for fun. Yes, they literally gathered up on an island, played musical chairs, but with each other's lives, and just got to kill each other. But no, we know that Kaido, Big Mom, Whitebeard, and Shiki were all on the same crew in their prime. Shiki, yo, that round of applause, Shiki, just for Oda adding Shiki into the story. But no, now that we know that all these guys were on the same crew in their prime, or on the same crew while they were in their prime, we do know that Roxy had to be an extraordinary leader, because to lead all of these guys while they were youngins, while they're at their strongest, goes to show you that Roxy himself is somebody formidable. And we do know that Roxy did go at the world government himself, because we know that now when you're becoming the pirate king, you got to go up against pirates and all the other rivals. But back then, when you wanted to become the pirate king, you had to go at the world government itself. And it's similar to what Dragon is doing, which is why I am appreciating all the stuff that we're learning about Rocks, because it is now seeming like Dragon, he's taking the OG old school route, and these all new pirates are kind of taking a different route. But either way, they're all going at the world government. So I do like the way how Rocks is being depicted. He's kind of like how Dragon is, or I guess we should say that Dragon is acting like how Rocks was. But boy, oh boy, the greatest war in all of history. Yes, I'm talking about better than any American war, any British war. The greatest war in all of history is the God Valley War, because 38 years ago, we found out that Roger and Garp, yes, Roger and Garp teamed up to take down the Rocks Pirates. And at this point, I'm just like, goddamn, Oda, you, like, when does it stop? Because, yo, now we know why Rocks and Garp basically did have their little beef, and we figured out how Garp ended up becoming the hero of the Marines by taking down Rocks Pirates, and we know that he had to protect the Celestial Dragons. But we now know why Garp and Roger, they were close friends, and why they actually did have that type relationship. So that just goes to show you that Roger and Rocks, back in the day, they were competing to become Pirate King, because the God Valley War, that was a place where everybody who wanted to become Pirate King went there. And the fact that Roger was there, like, Roger just popped up out of nowhere and was just there on the island, and then Garp came in there, and obviously they ended up teaming up. So I definitely do believe that Roger and Rocks, they were definitely rivals back in the day. And it makes me wonder, why the hell was Roger protecting Celestial Dragons? Why? I need to know that answer. Why was the Pirate King protecting Celestial Dragons? We need to know that answer ASAP, because yo, we already know Celestial Dragons, they look at everybody else as slaves. So the fact that the man himself, Roger, was protecting them, that just goes to show you that there's more than meets the eye between them teaming up. And we found out that Rocks was the creator of the D. Yes, he is the originator of the D clan. And this all makes sense. All I gotta say, Oda, is round of applause, because if Blackbeard is indeed 100% Rocks' son, which I believe it is, then it all makes sense on why Blackbeard and Ace happened. It is a cycle of family hatred. We know that Blackbeard's father hated Roger, and it will only make sense on why Blackbeard will want that smoke with Ace. He was like, hey man, you're the reason why my pops got killed, so I gotta kill you. So it all makes sense. And all I gotta say is great writing on Oda's part. Goda, I can admit, say that if Blackbeard is 10,000,000,000% Rocks' son. And last but not least, we did get revealed to the biggest bounties ever. Yes, when I say last but not least, literally Blackbeard's bounty is 2.2 billion, which, I'm not gonna lie, at first I was a little bit shook, but then I remember that he recently did just become a Yonko, so it is easier to understand. And then we got revealed to Shaxx's bounty, which is 4 billion. And these bounties are actually good to see, because I think that it's a good way to gauge Luffy. That's basically like saying Shanks is 4 times as stronger than Luffy. So that is what I like to see. And side note, peep how they hyped up his crew. Peep how they hyped up my boy Yasop, Ben Beckman. You guys see the profile picture. Like, you guys see Shanks' crew is going to be legendary. But Big Mom's bounty came out to be 4.3 billion. And Kaido's came out to be 4.6. And this is crazy, because that means that Kaido, he is closest to becoming the Pirate King out of all of them. Because Whitebeard and Roger, they both shared a bounty of 5 billion. And we know that Roger's, his was 5.5 billion. So it was slightly above Whitebeard. But we do know that Kaido, he is the closest to becoming Pirate King in my eyes. But we know that Dragon's bounty is higher than all of them. Yes, Dragon's bounty is higher than all of them. I'm guessing Dragon's bounty has to at least be 8, 9, maybe the 10, maybe? Because, yo, this man, the fact that he has a higher bounty than all the Yonkos, this is the most wanted man in the world. That just goes to show you that Dragon, whatever he's doing, this is a bad, bad, bad. Comment what you guys see down below. Subscribe if you haven't. Peace out.